The ability to read small sample volumes is necessary in many applications, but particularly in biochemistry, where one has to look at small sample volumes and determine its purity as well as its concentration. This application requires an instrument that can read small sample volumes yet maintain the sensitivity of the measurement. I would now like to demonstrate how the Cary 60 maintains the energy throughput regardless of the type of microcell or regular cell you use. Now, we're all familiar with the standard cuvette. It requires 3 mL of fluid to fill it. So now we're going to put this into the instrument as our baseline and see how much energy gets through a standard cuvette, and then we'll reference that to our other small micro cuvettes. So first I can take off the sample compartment lid, because the Cary 60 can measure with the sample compartment lid off. It has a technique or a feature called room light immunity, and that allows us to do enzyme kinetics reactions, quantitative analysis with the sample compartment open. So I will insert the cuvette now, and we'll take a measurement and see the energy. The second cuvette that we'd like to look at is called a macrocell. Notice it has thicker walls, and that of course takes up volume, but it still keeps the sample at the center of the cuvette. So this allows us to use a reduced volume as well. So now we're going to take and read that one. And this usually requires only about 200 microliters of sample. So I'm now going to place it into the sample compartment, and we'll repeat the measurement. The third cell we'll look at is called a biocell. It has a very small window. It's reduced in volume to about 30 to 40 microliters. And again, we'll measure this one. The fourth cell type we're going to measure, it's called a tray cell, that measures 1 microliter sample and can determine both the concentration and the purity of the nucleic acid, if that's what you're measuring. So we'll place it in the sample compartment and see how much energy we can get through with this arrangement. So as you can see from the experiment, that the first three transmitted the same amount of energy. In fact, all the energy that was coming from the instrument. The fourth cell, the tray cell, had a reduction, but when you consider that you were only looking at 1 microliter of sample, you would expect a little drop off, but you still have much higher signal to noise than you would with a standard designed instrument. The advantage of using the tray cell as opposed to a dedicated small volume spectrophotometer is that you can take the tray cell out and use your other standard cells for whatever application that you need to do. The design feature of the Cary 60 that allows us to get this energy throughput is from a feature called focus beam optics. What we do is that we focus our beam down to be 1.5 millimeters by 1 millimeter. So all the energy from the instrument is focused down into that point, and that's why we can get through these small volume cells and maintain our signal to noise.